Hello, welcome back to Dots FM and a happy new year to you all. This is Nikki, my name is Les. So what have we got this year?
This year we are continuing with Vintage Synth Top Trumps Mania because I'm winning.
I can feel the pain already. Top Trumps, we've also got some news on Arturia's Microfreak. Some exciting news.
I will be giving an update on my modular adventures, of which there's been many in the past 2 weeks.
And then we'll round off, as we often have done, with a little bit of electronic jam to go on your breadboard, as it were. So on with the game.
So, Vintage Synth Top Trumps.
Right.
Here we go.
I've not got enough cards to do that with.
That's because you're losing. Right. It's my go first. I am going for keyboard.
Keyboard. Keyboard is 32 keys.
37.
You know, I had the Moog, a micro Moog. Do you want to read it out to the listener, the viewer?
I can, yeah. You do not see it.
No, I'll tell you what. Use my readers. They suit you better than me.
I need them. Okay, the Moog Micro Moog. Designed by Jim Scott, the Micro Moog was an inexpensive follow-up to the Mini Moog, eschewing wood for a moulded plastic casing and three VCOs for just a single VCO plus a sub-oscillator. Instead of switchable waveforms, its continuously variable saw, square, pulse wave VCO gave some interesting results, especially when used with the inverted filter option and external input possibilities.
I got all that.
Me too.
And what was the winning card? That is your card, by the way.
Oh yes, I won. Okay, the winning card was the Korg 700S. In the early 70s, a spate of synths appeared, designed with controls on the front of the case so that the user could put it on top of an organ or electric piano and access its functions. The 700 and 700S, aka Mini Korg, were designed with this use in mind. Thanks to a great fundamental tone and the Korg LPF and HPF filter sliders, aka travellers, a legion of young enthusiasts got their first taste of synthesis on a budget.
Like anyone in particular?
Yes, I do believe that the Human League used it on their first single.
Oh, that's interesting, isn't it?
Yeah.
Listen to the voice of Buddha. Stop your sericulture. Little people like your offspring boil the life for some god sucking. Buddha's watching, Buddha's waiting.
As a lot of. Are we born to learn again?
He was popping out.
He's not even tight.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
It's not tight, it's a loose button there. A lot of people by now who own one of these. Who own one of these will know that there has been a very exciting update. Tell us about it.
I knew you'd say that. Well, I understand, not put it into practice yet, that it has several updates. One, it's got a unison mode. Two, it has three new oscillators that have been made by Noise Engineering. And finally, it's got an increased patch memory. So instead of like 256 patches, you can put 394 or something like that in. Is that the new oscillator?
No. Not yet.
So while Les gets to grips with the new oscillators and the update, we will recommend someone who actually does know about it, and that is Oscillator Sync. And he's got a good YouTube video on the update and everything that it can do. So we will put a link up at the top.
And now it's time for a modular update from Nikki. She's been slowly putting some modules together. Where are we at?
Shall I consult the book?
I often need to.
So I had the book, which I wrote down my to-do list on the modular.
Did that go?
Yeah, it's gone a bit more speedily than I thought it was. So one, buy a semi-modular, learn it inside out. I'm still learning on the Behringer Neutron. Yeah, think about additional modules. I did think about that very briefly. Well, no, I did it. And research options. Yes, I did that. Use VCV rack, which is the virtual modular rack, which I could highly recommend. I've used it a little bit. I got a bit too excited with the
Yeah, well, stuff. Christmas came along, didn't it?
They start buying modules. Now, I did start this last time, and I've subsequently extended it, haven't I? Mm-hmm. It was like Christmas in January,
and
deals and birthdays and stuff. So yeah, we nearly have a full row on the Euro rack, which we will go through in due course.
We've had a bit of help from a couple of shops.
We have. Elevator Sound, which we've been using for, well, before we went into modular, we used them for Bastel equipment.
Great shop.
Absolutely brilliant. They send us loads of stickers, so we're really happy. And Matek Modular, their Manchester-based shop, they've been really good and offered us some advice on modular. So I will be speaking to Matt in due course. Mm-hmm. With many questions, but he was just like, yeah, just phone us up, have a paper and a pen and a computer in front of you and we'll have a chat. So I think he'll be very insightful on the next steps that we need to progress with modular.
Thank you for your help.
Thank you very much. It's much needed.
We'll all be in touch.
So what else have I been doing? We've been doing a bit of patching, and I've been writing down in this book somewhere. Is frustrating you because it's not in the right
order. Why do you do that?
Writing down some patches. I've been looking at the Neutron, and the Neutron is semi-modular, so it has internal patching, and that makes a big difference when you're patching your Euro rack, because you've got to take account of this.
So is that making it harder though with the modular?
It's making it
having
harder.
Having to route it through
yes.
the Neutron.
It's harder and easier. So if you're just using the Neutron, it's easy because you don't have to patch anything to make a noise. And we have done a video, which we will publish at some point, where something was affecting something else. And I was like, why is this doing this when I'm expecting it to... It was basically playing a rhythm when I was expecting it to play a long note. And then, yeah, I've got some notes on the Bastel Popcorn. There's not many videos on the Bastel Popcorn, which is a sequencer. But it's a really good sequencer. It does random things, and it's
like
a bit.
That. I like that.
It's off the wall. It's really good.
Sorry.
Turn the micro creep down. Following on from that, we are going to leave you with a jam.
It's that time already.
It is that time already. It's a short one this time.
My beer's run out.
I was going to explain how I patched it all in, and then I just got too excited. We made some music and then unplugged it all. And anyone who's into modular, once you've unpatched stuff, it's really hard to get it back.
It all got a bit messy.
Yeah, we were in early stages of modular, so not sure. I probably just wanted to use the maths at the time.
Having said all that, it's time we weren't here.
It is, yes. So we will pass you
because
on to our...
Because your glass is getting low and I'm running out of beer.
That rhymed.
I used to write songs.
You still do?
Had you finished talking?
Yeah. Did it feel so?
Okay, bye bye.
Cheers, bye.
Had you finished talking?
No. But you were right to shut me off, I was waffling.
She does go on a bit.